And good afternoon. Welcome back to the second game of our SSN Canada.ca doubleheader here this afternoon. OUA East men's soccer action here today in the second game. The Carleton Ravens already having lost the first game of the doubleheader 4-1 to the Varsity Blues, while coach Sandy Mackey's Ravens picked up another 3 points in their lone game last weekend to remain in first place in the OUA East, with a record of 10 wins and 2 losses. A win or a draw this afternoon against the Varsity Blues will give Carleton the OUA East title. A well-balanced attack has been the key to the Ravens' success this year, with top scorers Jackie Simrolo, Andrew Latte and Sam McHugh all among the top 10 scorers in the OUA this season. And with this being Toronto's final regular season game and sitting 1 point behind the Ravens, nothing short of 3 points from this match will do for head coach Anthony Capitosto and his Varsity Blues. A win would vault them over Carleton, who still has a game in hand against Ryerson tomorrow. Capitosto will need top scorer Mario Kovacevic to be in top form today and add to his 11 goals scored this season to topple the Ravens. The last meeting between these teams was a 3-2 win for Carleton in Toronto on September 4th, with Jackie Simrolo scoring 2 of the goals for the Ravens in that win. So we'll take a quick rundown of the starting lineups. Toronto wearing all blue from head to toe, attacking the goal from left to right. Carleton white shorts and red socks. For the visiting Varsity Blues in goal, it's Russell Moore. Number 16, Dylan Bams. Number 15, Jeffrey Borgman. Number 11, Michael Brathwaite. Number 7, Lawrence Buchan. Number 6, James Gretorex. Number 9, Mario Kovacevic. Number 18, Ezekiel Luboki. Number 6, Scott Nisbet. Number 2, Nikola Ponic. And number 10, Ryan Shakitano for coach Anthony Capitosto. And for the host, Carleton Ravens, in goal, it's Mark Crocco. Number 3, Michael Kaloff. Number 4, Stefano Vieira. Number 5, Halid Sefic. Number 8, Sam McHugh. Number 11, Alexander Despotovic. Number 13, Christian Quasdorf. Number 14, Ryan Beckford. Number 15, Joey Kewen. Number 17, Josh Dewar Morris. And number 21, Andrew Latte. So very strong lineup for the Carlton Ravens. Unfortunately for coach Anthony Capitosto, he is missing two very, very important parts of his squad. Goalkeeper number 1, John Smits, is done for the season with a shoulder injury, from what we're being led to believe. And their captain and talisman number 4, Dara McGee, is out with an ACL injury for the rest of the season as well. So the Varsity Blues will have to go all the way without two very, very important players. Number 15, Jeffrey Borgman, has taken over the captain's armband from McGee in his absence. Toronto look like they're possibly setting out with a standard 4-4-2 here this afternoon. We'll have to take a look and see how that plays itself out. We certainly do know Carleton will be in a 4-4-2 position. Bit of a surprise to me, Josh Dewar Morris has been preferred ahead of Jackie Simrolo in the starting lineup this afternoon. But if he's had a good week of practice, then I'm sure coach Mackey sees something there that will make a difference here this afternoon. Kovacevic now working against Kaloff down that far side. And all to play for here as the Carlton Ravens sit with 30 points, as we said, 10 wins, 2 losses. Toronto 1 point behind them. So anything other than 3 points today, and Toronto will be looking at more than likely a second place seeding in the OUA playoffs. Crocco up into central midfield. Josh Dewar Morris can't win it, but he gets it on the second attempt. Breaks away from Luboki in central midfield. Plays it down to Joey Kewen. Joey Kewen. Oh, terrific reverse ball to Sam McHugh. So into the edge of the box. A great chance for Quasdorf. And a wonderful chance for Latte. Can he score? Oh, it's cleared the way once again by the goalkeeper. And finally on the third attempt, Russell Moore makes the save. Well, a terrific ball by Joey Kewen and a wonderful run. A reverse pass by Kewen for Sam McHugh to get on the end of it. He'd made a terrific run into the 18-yard box. And as the ball broke across to the back, I'm sure Quasdorf would have preferred that to be on his left foot. Quasdorf, Latte all had chances for a shot there, and my goodness, what a terrific break for the Ravens, almost right off the bat here. Kovacevic, nice layoff there for Greater X. He can't get on the end of it, though, and it will be Joey Kewin down that far side that breaks off of Brathwaite. I think it's hit his arm, and on a cold day like today, that must sting. So two up front, Josh Duer-Morris and Andrew Latte for the Ravens. Central midfield, Despotovic and Sam McHugh, with Quasdorf and Kewin out on the flanks. Nesbitt plays up only as far as Sam McHugh. Andrew Latte in an offside position, having come back from being behind the defenders. So that's with Nesbitt in central defence alongside Nikola Ponic for coach Anthony Capitosto this afternoon. Greater X tries to flick it on. Kaloff only as far as central midfield. It's in possession of the Varsity Blues. Nesbitt plays the ball up and over the top. Greater X down that left-hand side. Up against Beckford. Good ball into Kovacevic. It's poor, though, and it's cleared the way all the way into central midfield. It's now with Latte. Latte turning away from Greater X, but the Varsity Blue player does well to win it back. It's now with Nesbitt. Nesbitt spreads it over this far side now to Buchan. Buchan drives the ball down the right channel for Shakitano to chase after, but Shakitano does win the throw-in. The ball's played into Kovacevic. Kovacevic trying to turn away from two Ravens defenders. Joshua Morris can only play it as far as Shakitano on that far side. Vieira slides in, knocks the ball into touch for another throw-in for the Varsity Blues. Borgman will just leave it now for Buchan. Buchan the right back all the way down with this throw-in. Kovacevic turns nicely to the edge of the six-yard box, and it will be the first corner kick of the afternoon for the Varsity Blues. Here come Nesbitt, here comes Ponic. Two lads well over 6 feet that I think tower above just about every single Ravens player except for Sefic. And Sefic has taken up a spot at the front post well away. He gets the ball cleared all to the edge of the 18-yard box. Shakitano steps away from Josh Duer-Morris. He drives the ball into the edge of the 18-yard box. And it's now Vieira with a chance to clear it. Josh Duer-Morris breaking away down the right-hand side. Despotovic offside. Latte once again just has to take a quick look where the defenders are. There's no need to be getting caught offside. 15 yards inside the opponent's half. Some big games in the OUA last week, and unfortunately for the Toronto Varsity Blues, it was Toronto 0, Trent 0. 2 points dropped. That has left them in second place so far here in 2011. We'll get to some of the other scores later on. Brathwaite down that left-hand side. Joey Kewin tracking him back. Brathwaite goes beyond him and Beckford. Beckford does enough to knock it into touch. It will be a throw-in for Toronto. Deep, deep inside the Ravens' half. Ball's played into Kovacevic. Kovacevic trying to turn away from Kaloff. Does well. Oh, he's come along. The big man's done terrifically well inside the 18-yard box. And it breaks to goalkeeper Mark Crocco. But terrific skill by the big striker. Danced along the end line. There's a long ball just launched into the Varsity Blues half. Andrew Latte can't get there. And goalkeeper Russell Moore with a chance to knock the ball 60 yards into the Ravens half. It's a lovely sunny afternoon. A little bit cold. It's about 8 or 9 degrees here in Ottawa. A very crisp fall afternoon here, but the sun is out, giving us some warmth to hang our hats on. Joey Kewin now down that far side. Cuts away from Brathwaite. The free kick referee, Joe Audi, calls it. And it looks like it's, we're just trying to see, is that Lubocki on that far side? Number 18, Ezekiel Lubocki with the free kick conceded. And an opportunity now for Despotovic to come across with that right foot of his and a chance to swing the ball into the danger area. Sam McHugh mulling around there as well. Not really sure why there's two Ravens players over there. If you're looking at getting the ball into the 18-yard box, you need white shirts in the danger area. McHugh now comes away. Despotovic, right foot here into the front post area. Joey Kewin, that comes off the right side of his head, not the left. And that ball rolls out for a throw-in on the far side. A bright start here to this match. 7 minutes gone. Carleton 0, Toronto 0. In a match the Varsity Blues have to have here this afternoon. And even with a win today, they still have to hope for some help from Ryerson tomorrow. A Varsity Blues win today and a Carleton tie or loss to the Rams will give the OUA East to the Varsity Blues here in 2011. But a draw this afternoon, it's always a tough situation knowing that a draw is all you need. Do you sit back a little bit? Do you try and just defend some more? Do you try to maintain possession? Andrew Latte driving forward, right footed, and it goes well wide off that left-hand post of goalkeeper Moore. I don't think Coach Sandy Mackey is sending his squad out here this afternoon to settle for a tie. But you certainly cannot underestimate the value of players like McGee and Smits, who are now missing the rest of the season for the Varsity Blues. A major, major blow for Coach Capatosta as he looks to take his team back to the national championships that they hosted on such a wonderful occasion last year in Toronto, unfortunately finishing in fourth place for them. But a wonderful tournament, and I'm sure Victoria will do just as good a job for the men here in 2011. The women, of course, will be in McGill and Montreal, where fortunately that's where I will be commentating on all 11 games that will take place over the 4 days. So looking forward to that, and I'm sure Coach Bruce Wilson is looking forward to inviting seven other schools to Victoria and Centennial Stadium coming up on quarter-final day, Thursday, November the 10th. It's a free kick on that far side, right-footed. It's swung into the edge of the six-yard box. Kovacevic goes up for it. Borgman comes across, played to the edge of the 18-yard box, and it's high and wide by Lubocki as that ball broke kindly for him. Just couldn't get over the ball as it bounced up and easily high and wide. But Kovacevic certainly a danger when that ball's played into that 18-yard box. He's had an absolutely wonderful season. He sits fourth right now in OUA scoring. With only 10 games played, he has 11 goals. An absolutely fantastic return for a striker. And he's 5 points behind Robbie Murphy, the top goal scorer for Guelph, who unfortunately as well has picked up an injury and his status is in doubt. Well, Bucking certainly seemed to get all ball there as he went to ground. But Robbie Murphy of Guelph, quite possibly his season may be over. A chance to talk with Coach Keith Mathan, and he was saying that he's 50-50 for the playoffs coming up, possibly Wednesday for Guelph, certainly next weekend if they can negotiate a first-round match coming up on Wednesday. But there's an opportunity. Guelph could also finish in second place if they can vault above McMaster and miss out on that midweek match. Well, a yellow card handed out to number 7, Lawrence Bucking. I didn't certainly feel that was a free kick. I thought he did go to ground. He certainly did go down, but it looked like he did get the ball, and I'm surprised there that a yellow card was called. But referee Joe Audi far closer to the play than I am, and able to make the final decision in the end. A three-man wall for the Varsity Blues. Despotovic drives the ball into the edge 18-yard box. It's knocked up high into the afternoon air here in Ottawa. Kozdorf, a couple of chances to get on the end of that, didn't do so, and it breaks now for a free kick for Lubocki. Lubocki into Kovacevic. Kovacevic plays the ball inside to Shakatano. Shakatano caught possession but impeded the referee. And Despotovic just being asked to get back into a defensive position. Lubocki cutting away from Andrew Latte, left footed, nice little reverse pass to Kovacevic. Kovacevic a 1-2 with Borgman. Borgman to Shakatano. This is nice by Toronto. A great chance for Kovacevic. Plays it across the face of goal and coming in at the back. James Greatorex just unable to get on the end of it. But a wonderful sweeping move by the Varsity Blues down the right channel. And when the final ball went into Kovacevic, I'm sure there was a few current players ready for a shot. And he fooled everyone. Slid it across to the back post area. Greatorex just unable to slide in and get on the end of it. But lovely one-touch play by the Varsity Blues in that sequence. The ball's now with Bams. Bams can't get it to a blue shirt. And it's Brathwaite, quickly closed down by Joey Kewen, and the Ravens back to Moore. Well, a free kick has been given against Joey Kewen for a, looks like a push in the back. And it will be Nesbitt. Leaving it to Brathwaite. Brathwaite right-footed now, driving the ball up into the Ravens half. Kovacevic flicks it on nicely for Lebocki. Lebocki, a good midfield run, but he gets called for the push. So an awful lot of little touch fouls getting called here early as Joe Audi wants to keep things nice and tight. Does not want this game to get out of control. And the flow certainly not being allowed to go, unfortunately. Both coaches 12, 30 minutes into the match just questioning why so many free kicks, so many fouls are being called. But as we said, referee Aldi just want to keep a lid on this, not allowing things to boil over. Ponich does well. Borgman flicks it up. Shakitano late loses out to Sam McHugh. Bucking, who picked up that very early yellow card, has to be really careful now for the remaining, well, 75 minutes of this game, 77 minutes, because up against a shifty player like Christian Quasdorf down this left-hand side, you've got to be really careful. You stay on your feet. You do not go into a rash tackle. Josh Duermorris lets the ball bounce over his head. Couldn't see anything in the sun, I believe. And it is, with goalkeeper Moore, a chance to clear the lines for the Varsity Blues. Jackie Simrolo, the top Ravens goal scorer with 9 goals on the bench this afternoon. Andrew Latty with 8 goals, and Sam McHugh with 7 round out the three-headed monster, so to speak, for the Carlton Ravens. The ball now on the far side with Nesbitt. Nice ball into Brathwaite. Brathwaite plays the ball on the far side. Nesbitt's continued his run. That'll run into... No, he kept it in play. Excellent play by the big stopper. Cuts inside of Beckford. Edge of the 18-yard box. Sam McHugh just drives it into touch, and it will be a throw-in. So a wonderful ball down that left flank. Nesbitt continued his run extremely well. And it's now with Brathwaite. Brathwaite to Lebocki. Lebocki's flick-on's not the best, and it's easily cleared away by Beckford and the Ravens goalkeeper Moore. Has to come out, then come back inside the 18-yard box to make sure he can pick it up. It's now with Nesbitt. Greater X into Lebocki. Lebocki trying to turn away from a couple of Ravens midfielders. Bams into Kovacevic. Kovacevic's touch isn't the best. And it's Sefic driving the ball down the left channel for Josh Duermorris to chase after. Ponich will come across and just knock it into touch. However, he will get the free kick as Josh Duermorris just went through defender Ponich. So emotion's certainly on high here as both teams giving as much as they're getting. And the first goal today will be all so important. A bit of a surprising, the first game between these two, that 3-2 scoreline. You wouldn't have expected that many goals from two teams with such excellent defensive records. Carlton only conceding 11 goals, and Toronto, the best in the division, only conceding 9 in their 13 games. But that was the case, 3-2, all the way back on the opening weekend, September 4th. The Ravens in that win. Brathwaite now with the throw into Kovacevic. Kovacevic leaves it for Greater X. Greater X works nicely with... Oh, a lovely little flick by Lebocki. Lebocki to Borgman. Bams an awful long way out. And the ball's now with Andrew Latty. Couldn't let the ball run beyond him and has to check back up. He's got beyond Bucking. The ball's now with Quasdorf. Quasdorf back to Latty. Latty. Borgman does well on the tackle. Referee Aldi right on top of that with the throw in for the Ravens. And it will be Beckford coming all the way across from his right back position to take this. Long throw into the 18-yard box. Morris can't get there. It's cleared away by Kovacevic, and it will be another throw-in. Once again, Joshua Waters flicking it onto the edge of the six-yard box at the back post. Andrew Latte goes back. Scott Nisbet doing a good job to track him, and the ball's up to Greatorex. Greatorex trying to run the ball beyond Kaloff. Kaloff, what's a slight ball into central midfield. Oh, that's got to be a free kick. I thought the referee might have allowed play to continue. That was a golden opportunity for a break to continue down the middle of the park, and certainly the defender will get a yellow card for that. If he's calling the play back, then it certainly will be a yellow card. But I'm sure Coach Anthony Capitosto would have preferred the advantage to be going on. And it is Vieira now. So two players now in the books. One for each team. Buchan for Toronto. And Vieira, the left back here for Carleton. So both fullbacks have to be very careful now. Yellow card being shown to Vieira for the Ravens. So Buchan the right back for Toronto. Vieira the left back for Carleton. Both on yellow cards. And I'm sure their coaches will be asking their players to get the ball at their feet and run at these two defenders and try and draw a second yellow card. Either way, it's now Lubocki left-footed to the edge of the 18-yard box. Cleared away by Beckford. Only as far as Buchan. Buchan right-footed. Chipped to the back post. There's three or four blue shirts there. Not the best of deliveries. A little bit too heavy. But that's set up nicely for Toronto as that ball broke to Buchan, his final ball. Just not enough quality. And unfortunately for the Varsity Blues, it goes all the way behind for a goal kick. And we're still scoreless here. 18 minutes gone in this first half. Crocco up into central midfield. Despotovic trying to win it. Sam McHugh can't get on the end of it. He does deflect it though, and it breaks all the way now to Andrew Latte. It's too heavy for him. Ponich knocks it to Buchan. Buchan closed down by Latte. Tried to cut back in. Well, it's a poor ball. Well, he got lucky there with the free kick conceded by Latte. But again, Coach Sandy Mackey and the Ravens bench beside themselves as to why these free kicks are being called. Certainly referee Audi saw something there by Latte. The ball driven up into central midfield. Despotovic, not the best of touches, just knocks it high up into the air. He gets a second chance at it, and it's Ponich now knocking it up into central midfield. Sefic with a push in the back there against Kovacevic. The referee allowing play to continue. Good play by Greatorex on that far side. And a free kick called against Joey Kuhn. Well, dear, oh dear. Just no flow whatsoever to this game. Stops and starts, whistles all over the place, and both teams and both benches becoming very frustrated at the number of free kicks being called up by referee Audi here this afternoon. Brathwaite plays it short into Bams. Bams turns a little bit of time to play a ball to Kovacevic. I love the layoff for Borgman. Borgman into 18-yard box, left foot, tries to cut it back across the face of goal. Cleared by the Carlton Ravens, but only as far as the corner flag on the far side. And it will be a throw-in for Toronto. Borgman takes it into Kovacevic. He hooks the ball into the edge of the six-yard box. Buchan is in there. The fullback had made a good advance run. Well, Carlton not dealing properly with that at all, and as the ball was allowed to bounce around the 18-yard box, it was finally hooked away by the Ravens, but Kovacevic and his size really causing problems here this afternoon for the Ravens. Driven into the front post area, cleared away by Vieira. Not the best of corner kicks by Ezekiel Lubocki on that occasion. Buchan showing he's not afraid to get into advanced positions. That's a terrific layoff for Lubocki. Cleared away by the Ravens, only as far as Buchan. Buchan brings it under control. He's one-on-one against Kwasdorf. A ball played into Borgman. It's finally hooked away by Despotovic. And Carleton looking a little bit rattled right now. Midway through this first half, it's still scoreless. Oh, Sam McHugh comes through the back of Lubocki. A free kick called. I'm not sure if a yellow card's going to be shown on this occasion, but McHugh having a talk to by the official. And it will be Ryan Shakitano in his third year here at Toronto of eligibility. Right footed, he'll try to swing this ball in. Kovacevic, as always, will be looking to attack it. It's floated into the back post. It's a white shot that gets there first, cleared away by the Ravens. And Bams knocks it back in. There's about four blue shirts offside. The flag goes up, the whistle blows. And it will be a free kick just outside the 18-yard box for the Varsity Blues. Sorry, for the Carleton Ravens. So it's almost like a 4-1-4-1 set up here for Toronto, as in some cases Kovacevic is up there all on his own as everyone else filters back. Joey Kuhn, can he get on his left foot? He goes beyond Brathwaite, gets the corner kick. Oh dear, that's a bit of a mix-up there. Well, referee Audi seemed to have at least three or four players in the way, and it looked like it was the official on the far side had pointed to the corner. Certainly everyone thought it was a corner kick, but referee Aldi stepped in. He felt he had a better look at it, and he may have saw a nick off of Joey Kuhn. And certainly the goal kick was awarded to goalkeeper Moore. Right-footed now drives it up into the Ravens' half. Kovacevic wins it. It's now with Vieira on this left-hand side. Borgman does extremely well to win it. He's battling away with Vieira. Vieira has to be very, very careful already on a yellow. Kwasdorf can only drive it into Buchan. Buchan, it hit him more than anything else in the hand. Kovacevic claiming the free kick, didn't get it. Coach Mackey is going to have to be talked to here, because he's been up and down off that bench four or five times already. And referee Aldi just coming across and asking him just to settle down. A lot of the fans not happy at all with the early performance here by referee Aldi midway through this first half. But it's still Carleton 0, Toronto 0 in this top of the table clash between the number one and the number two seed Ryerson. I don't believe Ryerson, even if they pick up 3 points in their final game this weekend, they're already 3 points behind Toronto, and their goal difference is inferior to the Varsity Blues. They've conceded 11 goals more already and scored 4 goals less, so minus 15 to the good, or plus 15 to the good for Toronto. There's a drive by Lebocki. Not the hardest of efforts, appeared possibly might even have been going wide, but goalkeeper Mark Crockle goes down, the big 6'3" goalkeeper, stretching all the way across and putting it behind for a goal kick. Lebocki now, left-footed. Toronto has looked dangerous on these set plays. Into the front post again. It's not the best of deliveries, though. Such a height advantage, you're not taking advantage of that, and you're driving balls into the front post area that are easily getting cleared away by the Carlton Ravens. Brathwaite now with a good ball up and over the top. Not cleared by Beckford as well as it should be. Seffitz just knocks it up into central midfield. Brathwaite again. Well, not the best of touches by Brathwaite as that ball's knocked into touch for a throw-in for the Ravens. So lots of experience picked up last year by a lot of these Toronto Varsity Blues players as they hosted the National Championships last year at Varsity Stadium. They won their first game on the Thursday night. I believe it was the final quarter-final of the night. I believe it was something like 6-0 or 6-1, if my memory serves me correctly, against UCAM out of the Quebec Conference. But unfortunately, they lost in the semi-final. And then they did lose the bronze medal match to St. Mary's. So again, more whistles, more frustration, more arms being flailed by players, and just not the type of flowing game I'm sure that both these teams would like to get into here this afternoon. Despotovic is up for this. Joshua Morris wins it, plays it up to Lattie. It's to Joey Kuhn on that far side, though, against Brathwaite. It's a poor ball. It's now with Despotovic. Despotovic caught from behind by Greatorex, and it's now with Dylan Bams in central midfield. Kovacevic lays it off for Shakitano. Shakitano's ball played into the Ravens' half, but Lebocki will never catch that in a month of Sundays. Now with Beckford on the far side with the Raven throw. So Joey Kuhn really one or two opportunities to get in behind Brathwaite, but Brathwaite's pace able to keep up with Kuhn, and it's making it difficult for the Raven winger to really get some space and time to get balls into the 18-yard box. Lattie knocks it on for Morris. Morris now brings it under control nicely, plays it, tries to play it across to Kwasdorf. Well, it will break to him, left-footed. Can he do something with us? Plays it in the 18-yard box. Buchan has to wait. Joshua Morris comes across at the edge of the six-yard box. I think the ball hit him in the head more than his head hitting the ball. And it deflected well wide off the goalpost. But as that ball broke to Quasdorf, I thought possibly he might have lined up for a shot. When it broke into the 18-yard box, Buchan had to be very, very careful that he didn't put in a rash challenge, not only for a penalty, but to end up drawing a second yellow card. And unfortunately, Morris's header just went well wide of that right-hand post. Brathwaite chips the ball up to Greatorex on the far side. Seemed to get a bit of an arm on that, but it breaks into Vieira now coming across from his full-back position to knock it into touch. Toronto with a throw-in deep inside the Ravens' half. 18 minutes left to go here in the first half. Toronto 0, Carleton 0. In a game that's been stops and starts for most of the 27 minutes gone. A lot of whistles from referee Audi. He's been breaking up a lot of this play. A good ball to Kovacevic on that far side. He's onside. He's up against Kaloff. He shows him a little shimmy. A great chance for Greatorex. The ball's broken back. Buchan at the edge of the six-yard box. They're still with Greatorex. Left footy. It's a goal! Greatorex left footy from about 12 yards out. And that ball rockets into the top right-hand corner. In the 28th minute, it's Toronto 1, Carleton 0. Again, the Carleton defence inside the 18-yard box, not dealing at all with the second ball. And as it broke to Greatorex, he rifled the ball into the back of the net for 1-0 lead for the Varsity Blues. Joey Kuhn attacking down that far side. He wins a corner this time, and it will be the Ravens, who are now 1-0 behind with the corner kick on that far side. Terrific goal, just driving right through the ball, putting all the weight of his body behind that shot. A wonderful strike. Goalkeeper Croco with absolutely no chance. Left-footed, right on top of goalkeeper Murray. Does well. Well, well, well. The Carlton Ravens find themselves a goal down late here in this second half. In this first half, sorry. And they will need to strike back. As we said, it wouldn't be an out-and-out disaster for them if a loss here this afternoon. But it will heap all sorts of unnecessary pressure on them tomorrow against Ryerson. Ryerson, if you remember, came here last year and knocked the Ravens out of the playoffs, finished their season with a 3-2 win in the quarterfinal last year. So Ryerson certainly able to come here and get a result. Morris with a free kick once again in central midfield as this crowd becomes a little bit more vocal with the Ravens now down 1-0. Shakatano, a lovely ball chipped up to Kovacevic. Kovacevic, right-footed, oh, tries to go to the far corner, unable to get enough accuracy in the shot. But the warning signs have to be there for this back four of the Ravens. On numerous occasions, Kovacevic is just peeling away from his marker, finding space as the lone striker inside that attacking third. And the Ravens have to do a better job of dealing with the big man's ability to find space and get on the end of some of these balls and passes coming to him from midfield. Ball into Brathwaite. Brathwaite's not the best of first touches, and it will be a throw-in for the Carlton Ravens. Brathwaite flicks it up to the goal scorer, Greatorex, as he looks to get back on the end of it. Kaloff does well. It's now with Sam McHugh. McHugh tries to play a 1-2 with Joey Kuhn. Well, I just wonder if we, at some point, we maybe see Joey Kuhn being pulled across to this left-hand side. Brathwaite seems to be very comfortable in dealing with his pace. And with Buchan on a yellow card over here at right back, and Joey Kuhn obviously preferring the left side, I just wonder if Coach Mackey might look at bringing him over here to the left side to have a real run at Buchan and put him under pressure to possibly put in a rash challenge and be off here with a red card this afternoon. Either way, right now it's Toronto with the 1-0 lead. And quite comfortable. Carleton really haven't had an awful lot of attacking thrust here in these last 15-20 minutes. Sam McHugh, they've just resorted to knocking hot, long, high balls into Varsity Blues half that these two big lads, the stoppers, are easily picking up. Shakatana now with the ball plucked over the far side for Laboki to chase after. Despotovic can only knock it into touch once again. And the Varsity Blues, after that goal, you just see them settle completely down. Coach Capatosto has to be thrilled at the way this one is going here in this first half. Peter Manginis, obviously a big loss for the Carlton Ravens as well. He's out with, I believe it's an ankle injury he's picked up himself. But certainly Smits and McGee are huge for the Varsity Blues to be without those two veterans for the rest of the season. Joey Kuhn now, a lovely ball over to the far side. Buchan does well to read it. Cuts it off. Shakatana plays it back to him. Buchan will just hook this up out into touch in central midfield. Kovacevic couldn't keep it in, and it will be Halid Sefic. Well, he'll just leave it for Vieira to take in central midfield. It's over Buchan's head. It's over Morris's head. It's knocked up high into the air to central midfield. It has gone into touch for a throw-in for the Ravens again. Well, the last game we saw for Carleton was a 4-1 win against Trent, and the chemistry between Latte and Simrolo was there for everyone to see. Unfortunately, this afternoon, there just hasn't been that same connect between Josh Duir-Morris and Andrew Latte, and you just wonder at what point do we see Jackie Simrolo coming into the fray. Andrew Latte, a nice ball play for Sam McHugh, edge of the box, oh, penalty kick, it's got to be! Well, just trying to see what exactly is going on here. The referee hasn't signalled for a penalty kick. It is a penalty kick, yes. There did appear to be contact at the edge of the 18-yard box. As Sam McHugh played the ball in there, there was contact from behind. We're just trying to see who it is. It looks like number 11, Brathwaite, that did bring him down. I thought initially it may have been on the outside, but McHugh did look as if he'd broken into the 18-yard box. And a yellow card is now showing to number 11, Michael Brathwaite. And a golden opportunity now for Sam McHugh to tie this match up here this afternoon. 35 minutes gone in the first half. It's 1-0 Toronto, but Sam McHugh with an opportunity to tie it up. Goalkeeper Russell Moore up against McHugh. McHugh right-footed. Well, he's been asked to wait a little bit longer because there's some confusion here at the edge of the 18-yard box, but referee Audi will now come across, ask him to wait for the whistle. Well, I think the penalty kick was the right award for that. Sam McHugh right-footed. That's a great save by Moore! And it's kept out, and a free kick has been given for a foul against Sam McHugh. Well, not the best of penalty kicks, it has to be said. And a terrific turnaround here for Toronto when it looked as if they may have been conceding that goal off the penalty kick. Goalkeeper Moore with a good save. I still say it wasn't the best of penalty kicks. In a lot of cases, you've just got to step up and absolutely welly that ball into the back of the net. You try to be too cute, you outthink yourself. And the goalkeeper makes the right decision. If it's hit with enough power, enough accuracy, there's no way in the world he's going to be able to stop it. Well, a golden opportunity for Carleton goes a-begging. And they still have an awful lot of work to do to get back into this. The ball's hooked out to the far side. It will be a corner kick for the Ravens. So after a 15, 20, 25 minutes worth of a game where there was all sorts of stops and starts and whistles and no momentum, no flow at all, this game has livened up. A goal in the 28th minute by number 20, James Greatorex, has given the Varsity Blues a 1-0 lead. And then 2 minutes ago, a penalty kick missed by the Carlton Ravens. And it's Despotovic now, right-footed with the corner into the back post area. It comes all the way to Kaloff. Kaloff drives it back across the face of goal. It's cut out by Scott Nesbitt nicely. And it will be number 14 on that far side, Ryan Beckford, to take the throw-in for Carlton. All sorts of drama here in these last 10 minutes. The game's come to life, a goal and a missed penalty kick here this afternoon. Oh, far side, McCure, great chance, Latte, can he get on the end of it? He seemed to stop that ball from going forward. Despotovic charged down. Oh, they're all played onside by Nesbitt. Joey Kewen can't bring it under control, but it will be a corner kick. Well, again, there seemed to be some confusion. Lebocki thought that may have come off Joey Kewen, so all sorts of discussions, and the referee has to just call one or two players over here and just ask them to settle down, because this game right now has the potential to get out of control, because an awful lot of frustration, an awful lot of talk back to the referee and questioning decisions. You just have to, I know it's difficult, but you just got to accept it and move on and get back to get into your position. Left footed into the edge of the 6-yard box. It's cleared the way by Dylan Bams, only as far as Quarsdorf. He hooks it back up into the 18-yard box. Latte gets on the end of it. It breaks on the far side. And finally, Dylan Bams again, left-footed, gets it hooked away. And Greater X chasing after it. Well, we've got a chance for a quick throw-in here if one or two blue shirts get forward. They don't. And Michael Brathwaite will just slow things right down here. This is a throw-in for the Varsity Blues just inside the Ravens' half. Kivasevic against Kaloff. The big lad's done so well to break away from three white shirts. And Kaloff just has to put it into touch once again for another throw-in. Lebocki now trying to turn away from Despotovic. He does so, plays it back to Brathwaite, but it runs. Well, I thought it would go into touch, but it didn't. It's now with Nesbitt. Nesbitt looking ahead of him for a teammate. Plays it back out wide to Brathwaite. The Ravens doing a good job trying to close down the back four. It runs now for Lebocki. Lebocki trying to turn away from Despotovic into Kovacevic. Lebocki caught from behind by Josh Morris. Lattie's about 4 yards offside and had to check back out again. There's just not a lot of movement in there in central midfield when Lebocki was looking for a runner ahead of him. The ball's now with Ponich. Ponich comes all the way to the right back position. Cuts inside of Andrew Latte nicely. Still allowed to travel into the Ravens half. It's a poor layoff by Kovacevic though, but McHugh gives possession away. Sefic brings it down. A free kick for Toronto. We're inside 6 minutes here remaining in the first half. It's Toronto. What? It looked like Borgman may have been able to get on the end of that. Just hit a bit too hard by Ponich. And unfortunately for Toronto, it went all the way behind for a goal kick. Sefic can't win that. Kaloff can only knock it high up into the Varsity Blues half. Nesbitt wins it to Kovacevic. Kovacevic plays it nicely to Lebocki. Lebocki plays a nice ball down for Borgman. Borgman inside the 18-yard box. Left footed, tries to cut it back to the edge. 18-yard box. Kovacevic. Oh, what a terrific save by goalkeeper Mark Crockle. Kovacevic did extremely well finding space again inside the 18-yard box. As he turned, he was allowed to get a shot away. And Crockle just had to dive to his left high to make the stop to keep it from going 2-0 for Toronto. Short corner here, Shakatano now to Lebocki. Lebocki left foot, edge of the 18-yard box. Chips it to the back post. Kovacevic with the header on. Sam McHugh has to knock it up and out for a goal, a corner kick on the far side. So a tremendous spell of pressure here by the Varsity Blues. The Ravens fell asleep on that short corner. And as Lebocki chipped it into the back post, it was a lovely header by Kovacevic. And Sam McHugh had to be there at the back post. It'll be Shakatano right-footed. Six blue shirts in that 18-yard box. Kovacevic wins it. It's another save by Crocco. Ah, dear, oh dear. The Ravens are just not dealing with the height of this Toronto Varsity Blue attack here this afternoon. Dylan Bams right-footed. It's in there. It's clear. Oh, it's not cleared the way yet. Great chance at the back post for Shakatano. And it's a weak effort. But every single time that ball is coming in, when it gets beyond the first defender, Lebocki had one or two poor corners early that were cleared away by the Ravens. But when that ball is allowed to get beyond that first wave of defenders, the Varsity Blues are winning those balls in the 18-yard box, and the Carlton Ravens really have to do a better job of defending on these set plays. Vieira can't keep it in, and it will be another corner kick. Shakitano plays it short to Borgman again. Carlton leaving a two-on-one situation. The ball at the edge of the box, left footy. Can he get a shot away? Plays a little reverse pass, can't get on the end of it. Not cleared, though, by the Ravens. Nesbitt tries to drive it back into the 18-yard box. Joey Kewen blocks it. And it will be with just over three minutes left to go here in this first half. It is a throw-in for the Varsity Blues. The ball's with Greater X on the far side. He wins the throw-in again. He'll just leave it for Brathwaite. Toronto in no hurry at all, as they look to just get to half-time with this 1-0 lead. Shakitano being closed down by Despoto, which Borgman rips. Bams into Borgman, 18-yard box. Vieira comes across to clear it out, and it will be a corner kick. The flag has gone up on this near side. And once again, the Varsity Blues with a chance to bring Ponich and Nesbitt up from the back as they go for a second goal here just minutes before half-time. Let's see if they can deal with this one a lot better than they have the first four or five here this afternoon. It will be Shakitano. Again, they play it short, and only one Ravens player's out there. Shakitano will get a chance to clip it into the 18-yard box. It's allowed to travel all the way to the back post. Ponich will try to keep it in. He can only hook it wide. So at some point, you just wonder if Carlton are going to send a second player, a second attacker out to deal with these short corners, because every single time they're taking them, they're getting the ball into the danger area. It's not getting cut out. And that has to be a concern to Coach Mackey here this afternoon. The ball high into central midfield. Despotovic can't get there. It's now with Greater X. But it breaks to Lattie. Lattie's had a very quiet first half here this afternoon. You just wonder if there may be a striking change at half-time by Coach Sandy Mackey, as Lattie and Josh Stewart-Morris just have not been able to get anything going together. Greater X plays the ball out to Borgman. Borgman against Kwasdorf. It will be a throw-in for the Ravens, just about in line with their 18-yard box. Vieira to Kwasdorf. Kwasdorf flicks it on Sam McHugh. Loses out to Lebocchi. Lebocchi looking for some time onto his left foot. It's played out to Buchan. Buchan quickly closed down by Josh Stewart-Morris, and I don't know what's going on there. Just a little bit extras there between Morris and Buchan. Buchan, as he was trying to get up, Josh Stewart-Morris not allowing him to get up. And the referee's going to have to take some action here. So this was the simmering point that we were talking about. The referee, Aldi, does not want this game to boil over. And it will be Lebocchi. He'll just peel away, let Shakitano with a chance to just whip a ball into the 18-yard box. It's floated in once again to Kovacevic, goes up. Oh, and someone got on the head. I think that was possibly Nesbitt coming in there. He got the header. And it was hooked away by goalkeeper Mark Crocco for the Ravens. Throw in deep inside the Varsity Blues half. Can't be much time left. Certainly won't be an awful lot of injury time here in this first half. Beckford with the long throw into Lattie. It's over his head. Nesbitt gets it away. Only as far as Beckford once again. Right footed. He's trying to play it back in. Caught in possession though. Gets a second chance, and it's not the best of deliveries. Sefic turns his back, gets away with it, but his pass goes all the way back to goalkeeper Russell Moore, who has been one of the heroes so far in this first half with that penalty kick save against Sam McHugh. Not the best of penalties, to be fair. Sefic wins the header, but it's Lebocchi flicking it out wide on this right-hand side. Kwasdorf left-footed down the flank for the Ravens. It's Despotovic. Well, Despotovic and McHugh just haven't come to grips with this game here this afternoon. A ball swept to the far side. Joey Kewen can't get there ahead of Brathwaite. Despotovic, though, to McHugh. McHugh lets it run. Unfortunately, not the best of touches. They just haven't been able to put any sustained pressure in central midfield. And unfortunately, the three midfielders in central midfield for the Varsity Blues, Shakitano, Luboki and Dylan Bams doing an excellent job. And the first half comes to an end, 45 minutes come and gone. At half-time, it's the Toronto Varsity Blues with a lead on the 28th minute. Number 20, James Greatorex with the goal, left-footed into the top-hand corner from all of 12 yards out after the Ravens had not dealt with the first ball into the 18-yard box. We'll take a short break at half-time. Second half action coming up very shortly. It is Toronto 1, Carleton 0. Welcome back to Keith Harris Stadium here as SSN Canada brings you continued live coverage of CIS Sports here in 2011. Gordon Smith along for the ride with you this afternoon. It is Toronto 1, Carleton 0 at half time. James Greatorex with the goal in the 28th minute. And about 10 minutes later, it was Sam McHugh missing a penalty for the Carleton Ravens with a golden opportunity to tie this back up. So it's still 1-0 for the Varsity Blues. Doesn't look like there are any changes for Toronto as we look out there, but Carleton, I believe, have made a substitution. It looks like it is number 12, Olatobi Oluwole, who has come in up front for the Ravens to replace Andrew Latte. So Latte is gone for the afternoon. Olatobi Oluwole comes in to replace him up front. He just has to come off to central midfield before being waved to come back on again. So it's still looking like a 4-4-2 for the Ravens. No other substitutions that we can see. Just Oluwole, as we said, going in. So the Varsity Blues needing 3 points here, as this would vault them 2 points ahead of the Ravens and force Carleton to get a result tomorrow against Ryerson. A draw would do them no good whatsoever with a loss here today. And it's quickly Toronto in possession. Dylan Bams into Shakitano. Shakitano back to Borgman. Borgman nicely to Buchan. This is nice by the Varsity Blues. Good start to the second half. A ball into Shakitano. It's cleared away by Vieira. And it will break now all the way to Ponich. Ponich just plays it back to Nesbitt. Nesbitt closed down by Olatolli. A ball whipped up into the air by Vieira on the clearance. And it will be a throw-in for the Varsity Blues just inside their own half. Oluwole going in alongside Josh Dewar-Morris. Kovacevic does nice for a big lad. He's got such great touch. Greater X of all playing on the far side. Sam McHugh to Kwasdorf. Kwasdorf just knocks it up into centre midfield. And Carleton just have to get into some sort of rhythm right now, because they just have been second best for most of that first half. They can't afford to be here in the second. They've got to get back into this. They've got to put this thing to rest this afternoon. You do not want a nervy game tomorrow against Ryerson. Ryerson will be coming in fresh, not having any game today. They've only got one game left. A great season for them. 8 wins, 3 losses, 2 ties. 26 points. And this is another opportunity now for the Varsity Blues, as Ponich and Nesbitt come up from the back again, all the way to the back post area. And it will be Lebocki, looks like left footed. He'll get a chance to swing this in right on top of goalkeeper Mark Crocco and allow one or two of these 6 foot plus players to attack it. Lebocki left footed, there it is, it's to the edge of the 6 yard box. Crocco grateful to see that end up in his arms, and he launches a high ball for Oluwole to chase after. It's cleared away by Brathwaite. Lebocki clips it up. It looked like Kovacevic came back from an offside position, and it will be Kaloff with a chance to get something going for the Ravens here early in this second half on the offside. Right footed up to the edge of the 18-yard box. Goalkeeper Moore's coming off a long way for it. Good early shout, letting his back four know that it is his. And a good safe pair of hands as he was able to bring that ball under control. The ball's now with Brathwaite. Brathwaite looks like he's looking out to Joey Kewin, but Kewin can't keep it in play. And it will be a throw-in for the Varsity. Well, a throw-in's been given all sorts of confusion there between the assistant referee and the head referee this afternoon. But it's now Beckford with a chance for a long throw, looking for Josh Duermorris. Morris comes to the edge of the 18-yard box, flicks it to the edge to Despotovic. Despotovic challenged by Lebocki. Beckford, well, it's not the best of deliveries. It will be Bucking on that far side, getting there first. Bucking to Borgman. Borgman can get the speed to get beyond Vieira. He's going down the right-hand side. Greater X taking that position inside the 18-yard box, and Borgman can only drive it against Sefic for the corner kick. But Vieira certainly beaten for pace down that right-hand side by Borgman. And as he tried to whip a ball into the 18-yard box, it was deflected away by the big Raven stopper for another corner kick for Lubocki, left-footed with a chance to swing this in. And again, allow Nesbitt and Ponich a chance to get underneath it and attack it. Lubocki hits it right in the 6-yard box. A great chance for Nesbitt. Sorry, Ponich there, number two at the edge of the 6-yard box. Finally hooked away by the Ravens. But a good opportunity again for the Varsity Blues. You fear a second goal if you're a Ravens fan would really put this game to bed. They just haven't outwith of possibly one or two chances created enough in the attacking third here this afternoon. It's now Brathwaite. Plays the ball to Greatorex. Greatorex does well to turn away, but it's Sefic coming across. Brathwaite battling with Kewan. Plays the ball to Greatorex. Oh, he's gotten in behind Beckford. On, he gets clipped there, trying to allow play to continue. The referee does well. It's clipped in to the 6-yard box. Kovacevic with the flick header. And it just goes over the crossbar. Well, we've got a substitution coming in now. Alex Pelchat. We'll just try to see who it is that's coming off. And it is number 5, Halid Sefic. He will be coming off for the Ravens. So the big stopper coming off here early in this second half. You just wonder if obviously Coach Mackey has seen something he's not happy with this afternoon. Why the change maybe wouldn't have been made at half time. Maybe he's pulled up with an injury or something. I'm not sure. But either way, it's Pelchat now in the centre of defence. And it's Greatorex coming forward with Kovacevic. It's out to Shakatano. Shakatano with a chance, a second chance. And Carleton just happy to launch that ball anywhere right now. Well, I mean, the play was allowed to continue for a good 5-6 seconds there with the assistant referee's flag up on the far side and Carleton breaking down the left with possession. So a bit of a strange one that the referee called that back, but it's Croco right-footed up to Despotovic, which is over his head. All the while, he can't get on the end of that, and it's a ball player into central midfield. Kailoff does well to Despotovic. Despotovic trying to release all the Wally down the middle, but couldn't do so. And it's Ponich just driving through two Ravens players. It's Kwasdorf now looking for some support. It's Despotovic can't get it into the middle, and it's cleared away by Kovacevic. A lovely skill once again by the big man. Played it inside to Lubocki. Lubocki plays the ball nicely inside to Dylan Bams. Dylan Bams in central midfield. Not the best of deliveries. The best of balls into the midfield third, and that's quickly cut out by the Ravens. But it makes its way all the way back to goalkeeper Moore, who gratefully will just pick it up and be able to launch this 50 yards up the park. Q wins it, plays it up to his midfield partner Despotovic. He lets it run, and it will be Greatorex, who has the only goal of the game so far this afternoon. Plays it to Ponich. Josh Duermorris almost took it off him. Nesbitt left footed now down the right hand channel on the far side. No one there in the blue shirt, and it's Olawale now turning away and running back towards his own goal. Dylan Bams, terrific tackle. Nice little 1-2 with Lubocki, and it's now Bams looking to play the ball out to Greatorex. Greatorex caught from behind by Pelchat, and it will be a free kick for Toronto. 8 minutes gone here in the second half. A ball flipped up to Kovacevic. The ball was still moving. The referee not happy with that free kick, and it will be taken again by Toronto. Shakatano now going all the way back to take it for the Varsity Blues. upon. He's now right footer. He's got Nesbitt wide open here beside him. Decides to just play it into the edge 18-yard box. It's floated well. Edge of the 6-yard box. Kovacevic goes up there again. Brathwaite can't keep it in. And it will be a corner kick. No, the referee, assistant referee, has seen something. I'm not sure what it is. Offside against Brathwaite as that ball broke off of Kovacevic. And it will be a free kick and a chance for Crocco just to clear the danger for the Varsity Blues. For the Carlton Ravens, sorry. Joshua Morris flicks the ball on. It's Bucking. On the far side, Borgman now. Again, he's been a danger all afternoon with his pace. Kovacevic, though, wins the corner kick, and it will be... Oh, dear, oh, dear. Oh, the assistant referee ran all the way to the corner flag. His flag was pointing towards the corner, and then at the very last minute decides to change his mind and point into the goal area. A very strange situation here. Kovacevic obviously... knew that it was a corner kick. Anyway, Luboki left footer once again into that front post area. Oh, a couple of blue shots coming in. It's a great chance, Nesbitt. Joshua Morris gets it finally cleared away, and it's with Shaq Catano coming all the way as Sam McHugh's chasing after him. Keeps it in play, but it will be a throw-in for the Varsity Blues just inside of the Toronto bench. And a free kick given against Pelchart. Greater X. Well, Pelchart has to be careful here. And a free kick once again for the dangerous Shaq Catano to whip a ball in. Nesbitt's made his way. Ponich have made his way up to there to join Kovacevic in the centre of the 18-yard box. It's headed up by Despotovic at the edge of the 18-yard box. It's not cleared the way yet by the Ravens, and Kaloff just knocks it all the way out into touch for another throw-in. For the Varsity Blues, Brathwaite knocks it back up to Greatrex. Greatrex flicks it on for Kovacevic. He can't bring it under control this time, and it's hooked all the way up into the Varsity Blues half. Nesbitt has to go back towards his own goal. Olawale giving chase. He's still after him. Well, that is a throw-in. It certainly was touched last by Nesbitt. A good old-fashioned shoulder charge allowed to be given by the referee. And it is Beckford now with the throw-in. Into Joey Kuhn, who's had a very quiet match here this afternoon outside of about two or three little runs. Luboki comes across to help out, throwing Carleton deep, Toronto half. Beckford once again looking for Joshua Morris inside the 18-yard box. That's where it goes. It's cleared the way only to the edge of the 18-yard box. Not the best of headers. Kaloff comes in, gets a chance for a shot. Not the best of shots, and it's hooked away finally by Toronto. Kwasdorf on the far side against Greatrex. Greatrex knocks it back to Bucking. Bucking right-footed up to Kovacevic. He loses out, but concedes a free kick, and it will be the Ravens with a chance once again to knock a ball into the danger area. They have had opportunities few and far between here this afternoon. Early in the first minute, they had a glorious chance, two or three shots at goal that the goalkeeper Moore saved, and from there on, it's been Toronto with the better chances. Poor free kick cleared away easily by Luboki. Sam McHugh, the edge of 18-yard box, all the wall. He tries to play a little back heeler. It comes now to Kaloff. Kaloff drives it into the 18-yard box, easily hooked away. And Vieira now not the best of clearances, and it's now Kovacevic letting it run. Pelchat does well just to step in front of the big lad and stop his progress. It's up to Olawale. Olawale flicks it on Nesbitt. Lets it run all the way back to goalkeeper Moore. 32 minutes remaining here in the second half. It's Toronto 1, Carleton 0. In this top of the table clash here this afternoon by the two OUA East Giants, Carleton and Toronto. Kovacevic Vasovic using all her strength just to get the ball back to Brathwaite. It's bouncing around there. And over Kalov's head, McHugh flicks it on to Olawale. Olawale now looking to get beyond Nesbitt. Nesbitt, the big lad, does really well. Just plays the ball to Kovacevic. And it's now with Dylan Bams. Bams looking to break forward for Kovacevic. He's onside, looking to get into the 18-yard box. Couple of little stepovers. Rolls it to the edge of the 18-yard box. Greater X looking for a shot. The ball comes off him in the end, and it will be a goal kick for the Ravens. Kovacevic, as he got into the 18-yard box, just looking to play a ball across the top of the box. Dylan Bams looked like he had a split second there to make a decision on a shot, but wanted a little bit extra time and couldn't get a decent effort on target. Olawale does well to Josh Urmorris. Morris now looking on the far side, can't get it over there. And Despotovic can only knock it down the right-hand side for Joe Hewen. Nisbet hooks it away to Greater X. Greater X now to Pelchat. Pelchat trying to advance it down the right-hand side. It came off of Pelchat in the end. It will be a Varsity Blues throw-in. Good decision by the officials getting that one right. Brathwaite to Kovacevic. Kovacevic again just shielding the ball nicely. Good ball by Brathwaite to Lebocki. Lebocki gets caught in possession though. Joey Kewen spinning away from Greater X, but it goes into touch, and again the Varsity Blues in no great hurry with 30 minutes left to go in this second half. They lead 1-0 and things well in control for the Varsity Blues here this afternoon. A draw is no good to Toronto at all. That would leave them still 1 point behind the Ravens with no games remaining. So a win here imperative if Toronto are looking for the OUA title this season in the East, and will force Carleton to win tomorrow against the Ryerson Rams. Lebocki now down the right channel, plays it inside to Bams. Bams lots of time to find Greater X. Greater X, the ball's hooked away by Sam McHugh, but Bams, there he is once again, as he has been sort of just sitting in front of that back four of the Blues all afternoon. A holding midfielder allowing the other four midfielders to stream forward in support of Kovacevic, the big lad up front. So Bams has had a good game today. Stuart Morris, Joey Kewen now down the right-hand side. Oh, Dylan Bams may find himself in the book for that. It looks like he's being called back, and the referee, Joe Audi, might just be going into his book once again. Joey Kewen, for one of the few times he's been able to do so this afternoon, to get away from a defender. Had a couple of good runs in the first half, looked very lively. And then Toronto just started dealing better with the threat that he posed down the right-hand side. He will have an opportunity now, I'm sure, left-footed, to whip this ball into the 18-yard box. Seven white shots at the back post. All 10 outfield players back for Toronto to help on this free-kick coverage. Vieira right-footed now. It's far too close to the goalkeeper. The goalkeeper hasn't dealt with it. Kalov drives it inside. Oh, Despotovic with a golden opportunity 6 yards from goal. And all he had to do was beat Brathwaite. The goalkeeper came for it, flapped at it. One of the few mistakes he's made this afternoon. And as that ball went to the back post, I believe it was Kalov that just drove it all the way back across the face of goal. And Despotovic really has to do better from 6 yards out. Really, all it was needed was just a touch. He didn't really need to even try and drive the ball. He just needed to direct it towards goal. It would have flown in behind Brathwaite for the tying goal this afternoon here. But it's still 1-0 for Toronto. Pelchat to Olawale. He can't get there first. And it's now with the Varsity Blues inside the Ravens' half. It's a slight ball, though, from Kalov, another slight ball from Shakitano, and Quisdorf will just knock it up into the Varsity Blues half. Shakitano out to Bams. Bams taken out by Olawale. And it will be a throw-in once again. Sorry, a free kick once again for the Varsity Blues. Well, the central midfield this afternoon of Bams, Lebocki and Shakitana. We said it earlier, they seem to be bossing this match in the middle. And McHugh and Despotovic, unfortunately, have just not been at the races. Sam McHugh, just his confidence seemed to have gone since missing that penalty kick. And Despotovic there 30 seconds a minute ago, just with the best opportunity of the match for Carleton. Outside of the penalty to tie it up, couldn't do so. And that triangle in central midfield in that sort of 4-5-1 formation for coach Anthony Capitosto is causing the Ravens problems here today. Shakitana, right footy, front post area, great header, oh, good block. Just trying to see who that was that came across for the Ravens to make the block. He stayed down. It's number three, Michael Kaloff. A terrific front post run there. I think it was by number two, Ponich. And Kaloff did well to stay with him and blocked the header getting in behind him towards goal. Right footed once again, Shakitano with the corner. It's deeper this time to the back post. Kovacevic got up above Vieira and just unable to get enough power on it, enough accuracy on it. And it went safely behind for a goal kick for the Ravens. Bucking right footed, that can't keep it in. It will be a throw in for Carleton. Right at central midfield. Well, okay, he's taken it from a little bit further back than it really should have been, but Kovacevic bundled in from the back. It breaks to Bucking. Bucking stepping away from Kozdov. Kozdov does well to block it. Throw in Toronto. Midway through this second half, and the Varsity Blues still with this 1-0 lead here this afternoon. Borgman breaking forward. It's a slight ball though to Joey Kuhn. Kuhn can just knock it up front for Olawale to chase after. Olawale's gotten in behind. Oh, good play by Nesbitt. And the two of them collide at the edge of the 18-yard box. And the free kick goes against Olawale as he missed an opportunity to bring it under control. It bounced off of Nesbitt and Olawale's momentum took him into Nesbitt. And unfortunately, the free kick went against the Carlton Ravens in that instance. One of the few occasions a Ravens striker has been able to get in behind those two stoppers, though. The two big men doing a terrific job for the Varsity Blues here this afternoon at the heart of defence. The ball's now with Greatorex. He lets it run beyond him for Vieira. Vieira looking for a white shirt ahead. Oh, it's not the best of clearances, and it's quickly Kovacevic onto it, but goalkeeper Croco does well. And it's now with Joey Kuhn down that right-hand side. Nesbitt just launches the ball high into the Ravens' half. Kaloff has to go back. Second touch gets it hooked away, and it's now out to Joey Kuhn. Kuhn plays it inside to Despotovic. Despotovic can't get it beyond Greatorex for Sam McHugh. And it will be, well, finally cleared the way on the second attempt by Toronto. Kaloff out wide though on that far side to Kozdov. Only one substitution used so far by coach Sandy Mackey. You just wonder if he might be looking at making a second one. Jackie Simrolo still on the bench. I'm not sure if he's possibly injured or what's happening, but when you're chasing the game and you're looking for a goal, I would certainly be looking at someone like Simrolo to be coming off to not necessarily get a goal, but certainly create a spark. He's so full of energy, he's so full of running that he might cause this back four some problems for the Varsity Blues here in these remaining 22 so some odd minutes. But either way, it's still the Varsity Blues with this 1-0 lead here on SSN Canada.ca's coverage of OUA East men's soccer. The women for Toronto having already won the opening game of the doubleheader, so the men are going for the sweep here this afternoon and looking comfortable with a 1-0 lead, and the Ravens not having really generated much offence at all here in this second half, outside of possibly one or two efforts, the best of which fell to Despotovic about 10, 7, 8 minutes ago. And he missed a chance at the back post to tie this up. Kovacevic spinning away from two white shots that breaks up to Josh Duermorris. He can't win it, and it will be the Balky in central midfield, who has had a wonderful game for my money this afternoon. Dangerous on set plays. He's worked tirelessly in central midfield alongside Bams and Shaka Tano. And that right now is key. In central midfield, they've been able to boss the game from that position. Joey Kuhn with an extra little push in the back there on Greater X. The referee just having a word with him and asking him, I'm sure, politely not to do it again. And it's Shaka Tano again, right-footed with a chance to float a ball into the edge of the 18-yard box for Toronto. Justin Campos coming on very shortly for the Ravens. Goalkeeper Krakow has come for, he's fumbled it, he's missed it there. Krakow very lucky. And that's a poor ball thrown out. Dylan Bams, as he's done all afternoon, just mopping up in midfield. You have to say, so far right now, coach Anthony Capotosto has gotten his tactics and his set-up spot on here this afternoon, as the Ravens just haven't come to grips with this 4-5-1 formation here this afternoon. Buchan in a very advanced position. He picked up a yellow card very early in the match. One of three for the Varsity Blues so far here today. And he's done very well keeping his composure to make sure that he's not picking up a second. Kovacevic just inside the 18-yard box. Turns away from Kaloff. The ball's driven in and it's cleared away. I believe that was Despotovic getting a foot in to stop the shot reaching goalkeeper Crocco. But once again, it is a corner on that far side for the Balky and the Blues. Left-footed to the edge of the six-yard box. Crocco comes for it, gets two hands on it and looks to start an attack going forward for the Ravens. Oh, the Wally. Well, it looked like he'd given up on that and he just turned around and he was fortunate enough that it hit him right on the head. Borgman can't find Lebocchi with the ball, and it will now be Justin Campos coming in for the Carlton Ravens. We're just trying to see who it is. It's Kwasdorf now going off. I just wondered if Kewan will move over to the left side. Justin Campos, number 9. Well, Campos will make his way all the way over to the left, so Kewan will maintain his spot here on the right. And it's Beckford now with the throw-in. Cut out by Bams. Beckford once again with another chance to find Morris. It flicks up off of Buck into Olawale. Olawale right-footed into that front post area. Far too close to goalkeeper Moore. And it will be a chance for the goalkeeper to settle things down for Toronto. They really haven't been under any pressure here in the second half. Goalkeeper Moore's had a very quiet game in this period. Kovacevic closed down by Campos. Campos chased after by Borgman. Borgman does well, wins the throw-in on that far side. So good play by Jeffrey Borgman for the Varsity Blues. Lebocchi now inside to Buchan. Buchan to Borgman. Borgman back to Lebocchi. This is nice by Toronto. Lovely little flick plays. Sam McHugh finally able to get it, but it's given right back to Toronto. And it's all the Wally now trying to turn away from Buchan. Buchan goes to ground. Despotovic wanted far too much time in central midfield. You don't have that on a day like today. Toronto are all over this Carlton Ravens squad here this afternoon. All the Wally can't keep that in play. Well, yes, he does. Does well, and it's Ponich inside to Bams. Bams skips away nicely from Josh Duermorris, and Nesbitt just launches it up into the Raven half. As Beckford will drive it back towards the Toronto goal. Josh Duermorris flicks it up for Joey Kuhn. Kuhn working against Greater X. Greater X back to Brathwaite. Brathwaite caught in possession. He can only put it into touch, and Josh Duer-Morris leaves it for Pelchat to take the throw-in. Morris can't win that, and it's hooked away for Kovacevic to chase after. Kovacevic wins it there, and he's working away against Kaloff. Joey Kewin can't get on the end of it. It will be a Ravens throw-in just inside their own half. Sorry, inside the Toronto half, just in front of the Ravens bench. Looks like another Ravens substitution. Danny Gutierrez looks like he will be coming on for the Carlton Ravens at some point. And number three, Neil De Silva, will be coming on for the Varsity Blues. So a few substitutions now making their way on as we're inside the final 50 minutes. It's flicked onto the edge 18-yard box. Pelchat knocks it to Sam McHugh. Josh Morris goes up again. A great chance for Ola Wally. It's a header over the crossbar. And it will be a goal kick. So Danny Gutierrez coming in. And Neil De Silva coming in as well now for Toronto. We're just trying to see who it will be coming off. It will be Bucking on the far side, the right back for the Varsity Blues coming off. And for Carleton, we're just trying to see now who the substitution is being made. So De Silva on at right back for Bucking. And it will be Josh Duer-Morris coming off in place of number 19, Danny Gutierrez, who will take a spot wide out here on the right. And Joey Kewin will be pushed up front as a striker. Russell Moore with a long kick into the Ravens half. Sam McHugh with the header up into the air. It's all the Wally underneath. Bams goes for it as well. The ball now breaks to the far side. Joey Kewin does well to get behind a couple of Blues defenders. Tries to get beyond the third one, couldn't do so. Justin Campos down that left-hand side for some support on the original ball down to Joey Kewin. But again, it's Moore just settling things down. 14 minutes left to go here in this second half. Carleton chasing the game down 1-0. The ball's now with De Silva. De Silva, he'll just let that run into touch for a throw-in. No urgency right now in the Toronto Varsity Blues game. Of course, they can't afford to let Carleton to get even back into this. One goal will give the OUA East title to the Ravens this afternoon for this season. Lebocki just caught in an offside position. And now certainly the urgency in the Ravens play as Kaloff quickly chases after that. Well, it doesn't look as if Jackie Simrola will be coming into the action this afternoon. He's just standing there on the bench, not warming up at all. And I'll be very surprised if we do see him. There has to be, you would assume, some injury to Simrolo that's forcing him to stay on the bench here this afternoon, because he would definitely be one of the players I'd be turning to if I was chasing a 1-0 deficit here this afternoon. So Jackie doesn't look like he's going to be taking any action here today. And it is Beckford on the far side, a long throw into the edge of the 18-yard box. It's bouncing around a couple of times. It came off of Joey Kewin last, and it will be a goal kick for Toronto. So a quick look at the OUA leaders. Robert Murphy of Guelph, 16 goals in 14 games. He's all alone at the top. Alain Bedat for York with 14 goals. And Adrian Penna, the game-winning goal-scoring hero of the gold medal game last year for York against UBC. Once again, having another terrific season. He's got 12 goals. And Kovacevic with 11. Olawalu tackled nicely there by Nesbitt. Can't say enough about the job these two big stoppers have done. Obviously, with the loss of Dara McGee, an awful lot falls on the shoulders of Nesbitt and Ponich for Coach Capitosto. And so far this afternoon, they've done an absolutely wonderful job of making sure these Ravens attackers don't get in behind them. Beckford plays the ball into the front post area. Dylan Bams does well to knock it high out of the danger, but it's knocked back into the 18-yard box, and there's Bams once again, quickest to react. Justin Campos to Olawalu. He can't find Joey Kewin, and it's now with Nesbitt. Sweeps the ball out to this far side to Greater X. He looks to get beyond Pelchat. He does so, but Gutierrez does well to win the tackle. Sam McHugh. Well, it's just not been the best afternoons for McHugh since that penalty miss. But he wins a free kick. White shots being committed forward now. 11 and a half minutes here remaining in this second half. Carleton 0, Toronto 1 is our scoreline. Vieira, there's 7-8 white shots now in and around that 18-yard box. Vieira right-footed all the way to the back post. It's cleared away by Nesbitt. Oh, that's a poor ball by Pelchat, but it breaks nicely to Kaloff on the far side. Right-footed, can he get it in? No, he can't. Pelchat wins it, but it's now with Kovacevic. Kovacevic with time down the right-hand side, quickly closed down. De Silva needs to find a blue shirt. He can't do so. Joey Kewin flicks it on nicely for Justin Campos. He can't keep it in play. And unfortunately, a throw-in. Nice little piece of skill there by Kewin. Brought the crowd to life. They've been on their hands for most of the afternoon. It's a very cool, crisp afternoon in Ottawa. It's about 8 degrees game time. The sun has been out for most of this match, but it certainly is very chilly. No wind really to speak of, but just cold in the air. Despotovic now looking for his midfield partner, McHugh. Justin Campos wins the header, can't find Joey Kewin, and Peanuts just... just knocks it up into the Ravens' half. It comes off of Beckford, and it will be a throw-in for Toronto. 10 minutes to go. Well, this crowd that arrived here in anticipation of an OUA clinching performance this afternoon, sorely disappointed, as it's been the Varsity Blues that have been the best team on display here this afternoon, as the Carlton Ravens have really struggled to get any foothold on this match whatsoever. Certainly did have a couple of chances, none more so than that first minute when Lattie and Kwasdorf both had opportunities, I believe, early to get the Ravens off to a great start. They never didn't take advantage of that. Sam McHugh obviously with the best chance to score in that first half with a missed penalty kick. And it was Despotovic midway through the second half that at the back post all he had to do was just deflect it into the back of the net. Couldn't do so. And that's where we sit right now at 1-0. The Varsity Blues looking to bring another substitution on. Number 8, Jermaine Burrell. Burrell coming on. We'll find out who he's taking off in just a moment. But number 8, Jermaine Burrell, coming in to the fray very shortly. Beckford, the long throw into the 18-yard box. De Silva knocks it back out only as far as Beckford. He'll let it run out for another throw-in for the Ravens. No one really in a white shirt with the height to get on the end of these throw-ins coming in. Easily being cleared away by the Varsity Blues all afternoon. And there he is once again, Dylan Bams, as he has been for most of the day, just getting on the end of Raven attacks. Justin Campos clips it into the edge of the 6-yard box. Oh, it's a terrific chance that fell for Joey Kewin. I think he was caught in two minds that possibly that ball was going to be cleared in front of him. And as it broke to him at the back post, did have a chance for a free header and he couldn't do anything with it. Number 20, the goal scorer, James Greatorex, coming off for a well-deserved rest. He has had a good afternoon, certainly, with the lead goal here so far. With 7.5 minutes left to go, it's still the Varsity Blues with the 1-0 lead. Gutierrez wins ahead up to Joey Kewin. Kewin turns away from Dylan Bams, plays it through to Sam McHugh. McHugh trying to burst into the 18-yard box. Tackling against Brathwaite. Brathwaite just hooks it up into centre midfield. The two Ravens players collide. And it will be an opportunity now for the Varsity Blues. Dylan Bams just telling his Blues to settle things down. Good decision by the senior there, just making sure that the Varsity Blues try and see out these final 6.5 minutes for what would be a very good win for them here this afternoon. It might still mean that they'll finish in second place if the Ravens do the business tomorrow, and they will have to travel quite possibly back up here to Ottawa if the Carlton Ravens do end up finishing as the highest seed. But they have put a marker down here this afternoon to say that they can come to the nation's capital and they can get a result one way or the other against the Carlton Ravens. Shakutana went to Labocchi. Labocchi looking to play a ball into Burrell on this far side. He was never going to catch that as it went all the way back into goalkeeper Crocco. Crocco knocks it up for Ola Wally to win. Joey Kewin tries to get on the end of it. It breaks to Campos. A handball against Ponich. Ponich says it hit him in the chest. But referee Joe Audi with the call. And a handball. Just having a word with Ponich right there, asking him to settle down. Oh, looks like he's going to talk himself into a yellow card possibly now here. Just been told to walk away. Kovacevic just been shouted at to get back into a defensive position. There's no need for him to be standing in a wall. Despotovic, well, he scored the goal last week. It was more of a central position from the same distance, but will he take a shot on target? It's driven into that front post area, easily scooped up by goalkeeper Moore. It may have been going wide at the best of ways anyway. And the Varsity Blues now with 5 minutes to go, just trying to see this game out and force the Carlton Ravens to actually show up tomorrow and play to win, not necessarily just to play the reserves and the second stringers. Get them out there for a win that will guarantee them first place in the OUA East, because the way things are looking right now, they will end this match 2 points behind the Varsity Blues as they continue their terrific run here in 2011. The Varsity Blues Nesbitt once again winning that ball. Labocchi just trying to skip away from a couple of Ravens attackers caught in possession though. Vieira pushes forward. It's on the far side. Justin Campos. Campos trying to get a drive in. It comes off the defender. It will be a corner kick for the Ravens. Well, you just wondered if Crocco's been looked at with 4 minutes left to go to be coming up here. I think it's still a bit early for something like that. But everyone pretty much in a white shirt coming up. Crocco's made his way up to central midfield. Every outfield player in a white shirt within 25 yards. Whipped into the front post. A very poor corner kick. Pelchart has to get it back into the danger area quickly. He cannot get caught in possession like that. He got very fortunate that Burrell was not able to get that ball to Kovacevic. It's now Crocco right-footed up to the right channel. Sam McHugh tries to flick it on Nesbitt once again. An absolute tower of strength back there all afternoon. Well, there's quite a few players in blue here this afternoon that have to be considered for our SSN Canada player of the game. Burrell is onside. Oh, that's got to be a free kick. Oh, it certainly did look as if that was a free kick as Burrell went to ground. It definitely did look as if it was late and a little bit reckless. Unfortunately, it wasn't called for the Blues. Well, this does have the potential in these final 3 or 4 minutes to really boil over, but right in front of the Toronto bench, that now is Despotovic going into the book. So 5 yellow cards this afternoon, 3 for Toronto, 2 for Carleton. And unfortunately for the Ravens, it's still 1-0 on the scoreboard, 2 are left. Well, just approaching 5 o'clock Eastern here. There's less than 3 minutes left to go. Carleton have to pull something out here this afternoon. De Silva chips the ball into the edge 18-yard box. Cleared away by Vieira to Sam McHugh. McHugh now looking to play a ball out to Campos. Campos' first touch takes him away from Borgman, but the Blues captain does well to win it back, and it's played off of Despotovic on that far side for a throw-in to the Varsity Blues. 2 minutes remaining here now of the 90. Can't be much time added on, surely. Maybe 3 minutes, 2 minutes, you would think. No injuries to speak of, but there have been 4 or 5 substitutes that have come on in the second half. So more than likely 2, possibly 3 minutes being added on. Kovacevic just knocks it as far as he can all the way down. Behind the goal, it will be Crocco with a chance to get it up into midfield for the Ravens. They need a spark. They need something to get back into this match, get the point that will win the OUA's title for them. Lebocchi on a breakaway down the right-hand side against Vieira. Cuts onto his left hand. His left foot, not the best of shots away. Crocco will have a chance as the Ravens commit bodies forward. The counter-attack will be there for the Varsity Blues. And there's Nesbitt once again with the header. So at this point, we start thinking about player of the game. I'm going to hold off until the final whistle has gone. Then we will get to the player of the game, because there have been a few of them for the Varsity Blues here this afternoon. Kovacevic has led the line extremely well for Toronto. And the four attacking midfielders have done a terrific job of getting forward to support them. They got the all-important goal midway through that first half. And they've held on here. To be fair, they haven't been put under enough pressure by the Carlton Ravens this afternoon. In central midfield, I think that group of three, Lebocchi, Shakitano and Dylan Bams, have been excellent. They've really not allowed the Ravens any possession in central midfield. And above all else, they've just been harrying Sam McHugh and Despotovic all day. And it's been nigh impossible for them to have any success up into central midfield. Once again, it's Dylan Bams going up there. We have talked about the two stoppers being terrific here this afternoon for the Varsity Blues. Beckford goes in, takes Lebocchi right out there. Lebocchi goes to ground. So both Ponich and Nesbitt have been exceptional at the centre of defence. We talked about the three midfielders. We talked about the big lad up front, obviously having a wonderful game this afternoon himself, Kovacevic. But I'm going to give player of the game to Dylan Bams. I think he's been absolutely fantastic in central midfield, just sitting in front of the back four, not allowing any Carlton midfielder, if McHugh or Despotovic were able to get beyond Shakitano and Lebocchi. Dylan Bams was there every single time to stop that progress. He was winning balls in the air. He was winning tackles in central midfield. He was bringing teammates into play wide up front when it had to be, just putting the foot on the ball to settle things down for the Varsity Blues. He did that so well all afternoon. And for his performance here today, our SSN Canada player of the game is number 16, Dylan Bams for the Toronto Varsity Blues, who now look as if they've done more than enough to vault over the Carlton Ravens into first place as play draws to a close here this evening in the OUA East. There's still all to play for the Ravens, but now they will have to pull out a victory tomorrow. Anything less than 3 points, and they will finish in second place. Goalkeeper Crocco again making his way up into central midfield. As all the white shirts have been pushed forward now, there's final chance to pull it out. There's Dylan Bams winning the header, but he has to concede the corner kick. Could this be the final chance for the Ravens? Crocco's all the way up. There are no white shirts or goalkeeper outside of the 18-yard box. Despotovic needs a good delivery. It's on top of the goalkeeper. It looks like it's a goal kick, and that must be the final chance this afternoon for the Carlton Ravens, as that ball was whipped into the front post area. Toronto doing just enough to make sure it got cleared away, and it came off a Ravens attacker. The referee already has had a look at his watch. The final whistle is imminent here at Keith Harris Stadium. Still enough possibly chance for the Ravens. One last push forward. Everyone again driving forward in a white shirt. It will be a throw-in. Beckford, does he have the arm strength to get the ball 40 yards all the way into the danger area? It's into the edge of the 6-yard box. It's Kovacevic clearing it away. Kovacevic, sorry, clearing it away. Borgman, Sam McHugh looking to clear it. And now this counter-attack is possibly on for the Varsity Blues. I think it'll just be a case of knocking it down into the Ravens' half, not being worried about going for goal. Lebocki just drives the ball off of Pelchart on that far side, and it will now be the final substitution coming in for the Varsity Blues. It will be Lukovic coming in, number 22. Number 22, Lukovic coming in for what has to be the final 15, 30 seconds. And it will be number 10, Ryan Shakitano, who himself has had a wonderful game this afternoon in central midfield alongside our player of the game, number 16, Dylan Bams for Toronto. So Carleton won in Toronto early on in the season. It looks like the Varsity Blues are going to win here in Ottawa at the end of the season. And there goes the final whistle. 90 minutes have come and gone. And Anthony Capatosto's Varsity Blues squad find themselves sitting atop the OUA East at the end of play today here with 32 points. 10 wins, 2 losses and 2 ties. 38 goals for, 9 goals against, as they now vault above the Ravens and sit in first place. However, the Carlton Ravens will have an opportunity tomorrow with a win to wrap up the OUA East title here in 2011. It won't be easy. The Arson Rams are a tough team. They have salted pretty much third place, while Queen's still with a chance, but Ryerson look like they may be in a fairly comfortable position as that number 3 seed. Certainly they will be hosting a playoff game in midweek as either number 3 or number 4, depending on how Queens finish out their season. But it is Toronto with a huge win here this afternoon. They've defeated the Carlton Ravens. The final score from Keith Harris Stadium is Toronto 1, Carlton 0.